What's going on, everybody? It's Stas here. In today's video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're also going to be doing a trading update, talking about what I did today on the 25th of July in 2019 in terms of my trades, as well as going over some other stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching and looking to trade here heading into the month of August in 2019. So if you enjoy this video, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. If you want to see further content from me, consider subscribing, and let's get right into it, guys. So today, the S&P actually pulled back $15.89. It had a red day of 0.53%. The Dow Jones Industrial Average down 129 points today, down 0.47%. And the NASDAQ today down $53, down 0.65%. So overall, guys, today and across the markets, across the three indexes that we track on this channel, the markets were red, right? The markets were red. And let's go back to the S&P. Let's break down some technicals very quickly so we can see what to expect, right? And on the broad basis here on the 184-hour chart, we can see that the S&P is actually maintaining this 50 simple moving average right now after the dip from 3019 that we saw yesterday, which happens to be the all-time high. So the fact that we are holding the 50 SMA right now, we are seeing a green candlestick forming on top of it. That's a good sign that we are holding the uptrend at a higher low from the previous. One thing that's not too good right now, in my opinion, is that this could be a double top on the S&P 500. We remember the all-time high previously was at about 3015 to about 3016, and that's literally right at the level that we topped out at. I know it's not exactly, but it's literally right there, guys. So that, in my eyes, in my books, constitutes as a double top and from what I'm seeing right now. And what we would see, you know, the full-on bearish breakout, what would that be, right? The bearish breakdown would be if we, again, broke that 50 SMA, which we are holding right now. So as of now, it looks like we do want to pop, but let's say we gap down tomorrow again, we may be, you know, breaking that 50 SMA, which again is very bearish. And if we go out very quickly, guys, you know, if I just zoom out a bit, and if we go to the handy dandy little support and resistance tool that I use, we can see some levels on the S&P that may be coming up here if we do decide to continue to sell off, if the markets continue to sell off. So you see one here at 29.50. That's a support level that I'll be watching heavily. The next one's at about 29.75. You can see we held that back on the 19th of July, back in the beginning of July as well. This in general is a very strong level, and if we broke that, guys, there's probably another one, I'd say around 29.60, which is in the middle of this 29.50 to 29.75 channel. So as of now, 3,000, we need to hold it, in my opinion. You know, 3,000 as well as a support, now that I'm thinking about it, you know, we need to hold this to continue the uptrend. And I've been mentioning 3,000 religiously, I feel like, over the past couple of videos, and it still stands right now. And if we break that, again, we'll be breaking the 50 SMA. We may be going back down to 29.75. So let me just quickly change the drawing tool, then we'll go to the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and we'll do some breakdowns here. So interestingly enough, the Dow is also holding that 50 SMA on the 184-hour chart as a support, just like the S&P was, right? You can see it again, right? The Dow is holding that level, so this, in my opinion, is still technically downtrending. We didn't break that key level and dump. If we do, that would be a very bearish reversal to the downside. And if we're going a bit closer here, let's say on the 20-day 1 hour, you guys can kind of see, if I redraw this, let me just quickly remove this drawing. It does not look too good. I mean, let me just clear the whole drawing set while I'm at it. You guys can see that we're kind of in a wedge, in a sense, right? actually more like a downwards trending channel at this point. Check, take a look at that, right? We hit 27,400. We hit a low at 27,000. We popped up lower high, right? We popped down. We held that support. And we've honestly been holding this support in general over the past 3, 4, 5 trading days. So it's interesting now. Are we going to break the support, maybe break the bottom of this channel and break that 180 SMA and then continue, or rather start a bear trend there? Or are we going to pop out and break the resistance and that 50 SMA, which is going to be a very bullish breakout? So those are just a couple of scenarios I'm watching right now on the Dow Jones Industrial Average. And it's really gotten itself in this very interesting spot right now, which the next couple of days, guys, it's going to pick a direction. We just need to see, is it going to be upwards or downwards? And from there, we'll be able to plan out some trades. So that's the Dow analysis. Let's go to the NASDAQ very quickly, guys. You can see the NASDAQ as of yesterday, we broke out of the resistance of this downwards trending pattern here of lower highs. You guys can see it. We broke out, which was very good, and I mentioned this in yesterday's video. If we were to pull back, we needed to hold this level as a new support, which was the resistance, again, of that downwards trending channel. So it seems like we did end up dipping a bit below it. We tested that 180 SMA. We held that. We popped, and now we're trading above that old resistance again, looking like we are holding it as a support, and honestly looking to continue this rally in the NASDAQ for a potential all-time high again here. That's kind of what I'm seeing on the 20-day 1 hour. Let me know what you guys think down below. And if we go out even further, you can see this is simply a dip. We're holding that 50 SMA on the 6-month chart at a higher low, and this could really just be a launching pad up to the next all-time high here for the NASDAQ. So that's it for the market update, guys, the market update portion of this video. If you enjoyed it, let me know, what do you think about the markets? What do you think the stock market is going to do here in the next couple of days? Bearish, bullish, your opinions, drop them down below. So let's quickly now do a trading update. What did I do today? You're probably wondering, what happened with my FedEx swing trade? I'm actually still holding on strong to FedEx because I'm in at a very good average price right now. If you guys remember, and if we go to FedEx very quickly, you guys remember that I got in on this day, I believe, at about $169.80. From there, it ran up all the way to $178 in the matter of a day or two. Very quick run. And then we got the pullback. And then I ended up adding more, I believe, at like $175, or this was yesterday, rather, at $175-ish, $175.50. I forget exactly, but you guys saw it in yesterday's video, right? And now we got to see another healthy pullback. Which, if you guys remember my video yesterday, I actually said that FedEx could potentially pull back to 175 again and maybe consolidate there as a higher low before launching up and maybe testing $180. And this is, at this point, this is what I'm thinking is happening right now. And again, I could be 100% wrong, right? I could be 100% wrong, but I think this was the healthy pullback that FedEx needed to see. Now we're holding 175 strongly, and if you go to the 1 day, 1 minute, you'll be able to see that very clearly. And let me show you guys here. You can see 175, you know, we really hit that spot once, twice, 3, 4, 5 times throughout the day, and we held above it. We didn't dip below it at all. We literally held above it and ended up closing the day on an upswing. So this led me to really be comfortable holding this swing trade overnight again and potentially adding more money tomorrow. And in the grand scheme of things, guys, if we go to the 5 day, 5 minute, and we do a little, draw out of the pattern, the pattern's still intact, right? Take a look at that. The pattern's still intact. We held a higher low today from the previous, and we close on a little upswing. Now, ideally, I would like to gap up tomorrow. Hopefully, we gap up to 176.50, 177, maybe 178, or maybe we consolidate a bit more before creeping up maybe later in the day tomorrow or in next week's trading session, right? So these are just a couple scenarios, but now I still feel comfortable holding FedEx. But my day trade of the day today, and if you guys are in the Discord group chat, join the Discord, or if you're not in the Discord group chat, rather, you probably didn't see me call this out, but if you are, you did see it. And if you haven't gotten in there, guys, the link is the pinned comment down below in the comment section. It's 100% free. Get in there. But the JNUG call this morning, I ended up capitalizing on it, and we can see here, guys, despite looking at JNUG's chart, I know it's very ugly looking. Let's take a look at the gold futures chart very quickly, because this is what JNUG trades based upon, right? Gold. And we saw gold took a very, very sizable pullback over the past couple of days, and now it's holding a higher low on the 180 SMA here on the 6-month chart. And I noticed this morning when I traded it. I forget exactly where it was. I think it was a bit higher than here. But anyway, I noticed this morning, you know, it was a falling knife, but we were still trending above the previous low at a higher low and above that 180 SMA. So I figured this could be a bounce back play here, since we've sold off from 1450 down to about where we are now at 1415. And in the morning, we were at like 1420 or something like that. And we did get that slight bounce. You know, we got that slight little run this morning, right? We got the sell-off from 1430 again. We were downtrending. This was at Eastern Standard Time. We downtrended to about when the market opened, and we got, and what did we get when the market opened, guys? About like 5-10 minutes into it, we got this wedge in the gold futures, and you guys can see what I'm drawing right now. This is a wedge right here, right? And then we broke out of that wedge, and this turned into a pretty bullish move where gold ended up rallying for a little bit up to about 1422. And if we take a look at JNUG, you know, let's go take a look at JNUG. Once we broke out of that wedge, JNUG started to run a bit as well during this time period. And this is actually when I caught it. It was very quick, guys, because this morning, again, we saw gold dumping aggressively, and JNUG was dumping very aggressively from $87 down to about $79. So at this point, I was kind of scared to catch a falling knife. I'm not going to lie to you guys. But once we bottomed at $78, we popped, we got hit by the 50, we pulled back, we held a higher low, and then once we broke out, that's when I started to just build a little position. It was actually before $80, actually. It was at about like $79.85 or something like that, and then we started to break out, and I ended up selling my position. It was at about like $81.30. So from about $79.88, $79.80, up to where I ended up selling out, it was about like a 1.6 to a 1.8% profit. Very quick profit on JNUG. And this is one, honestly, guys, that if you weren't actively watching it, the move was so quick that you probably would have missed it. But since I was watching it, and again, I called it out in the chat, it was literally on my screen, I was able to catch it, and I was able to capitalize on JNUG. So let me know down below, what did you end up doing today in terms of your trades? What are your upcoming predictions with different stocks, ETFs? I would love to know. And my phone's been actually going crazy about Starbucks. I got an alert from Robinhood. Starbucks announced quarterly earnings of 78 cents per share, beating expectations by 8%. So let's just jump into that portion of the video talking about stocks, and might as well just start off with Starbucks, guys. And oh my goodness, this stock went from $90 up to $96 on that 8% beat or whatever it was. Yup, 8%. Holy crap, guys. Take a look at that. Wow. And Starbucks has been one of those companies that has just been uptrending like crazy. Really no pullbacks, minimal pullbacks, just straight uptrending. And the stock was $60 a couple of months ago. Now it's almost $100. That's absolutely crazy. So at this point, guys, Starbucks, it's very overbought. If it does open at this level, which it might, right, if the hype stays, you know, it might open at 96, 95. If we get the pullback maybe to the lower 90s and we start to consolidate there, maybe on the 50 SMA at that point, this could be a point in time where Starbucks could offer a nice dip. And obviously, again, it's been uptrending and it's been using that 50 SMA as a support over the past couple of months. So honestly, I think that could be a very possible trade If we do end up pulling back, in my opinion, I think it will cool off. Remember, they just reported earnings. This is initial hype. So this might even drop in the next hour or two. We just have to wait and see. But once it does, if it pulls back, right, you know, I think this will be a very good potential entry point. Another earnings play today was 3M, ticker symbol MMM. And oh my God, did it drop all the way back down? I didn't even realize that till now. But this one actually gapped up to $190 this morning, guys. This is absolutely crazy, right? And I believe their earnings, let me just double check it very quick. I think they beat, but I forget. Okay, here it is. 2.2 EPS versus 2.06 estimate. Sales at $8.17 billion beat the $8.03 billion estimate. So very good earnings there in terms of EPS and revenue. And at this point, guys, this might open up a very interesting play tomorrow because it fell $10 from when it peaked pre-market. That's pretty crazy right there, guys. That is pretty crazy. And now we're holding, it seems like, 178, which was an old resistance as a new support. This could be a gap fill up to 183 tomorrow, guys. Watch this because the earnings were good. This is a very exaggerated pullback, in my opinion. I can't believe it actually pulled back that much. But anyway, that's actually opening up a good opportunity for us traders. We can maybe potentially hop into this, right? So 3M could fill up. I'm watching it, you know, on the 184-hour chart. It's looking quite promising at this point. We just need to hold 178, though. That's the key right there. If we break 178, that might be bad. We might be going back down to 173. So that's kind of what I'm watching in terms of 3M right now. Off the top of my head, what other stocks were there? 3M, Snapchat, that's another one. Oh, and PayPal, that's the one we need to look at, guys. So Snapchat right now took another jump to $18. It's kind of hovering here at an overbought spot. So at this point, I'd like to see Snap maybe pull back to low 17s, maybe. If it really got down to the 16s, guys, 16.50, that would be a nice spot, to be honest, if we retested that and held it as a support. And if we go to PayPal, guys, let's take a look at PayPal. So PayPal at this point, we called it out in yesterday's video. Nothing much happened. It was down 5% today, as you guys can see, due to their earnings report. But one spot that we're still holding above is the 180 SMA here, which is this yellow line. So if we are able to potentially curl up here after, you know, in tomorrow's session, maybe after this week, maybe next week, you know, this could be a spot where we could get in a dip if we start to test higher highs, maybe 122, maybe even an all-time high, right? So PayPal at this point, I'm liking the dip, but if it does break significantly down into the low 110s, 100s, at that point, in terms of swing trading, not too interested, in my opinion, not too attractive if it breaks this key technical spot, but it hasn't yet, which is why it's still on my list. So those are just a couple that I'm watching, guys. If the markets continue to get rocky tomorrow, I always got my market ETFs on deck here, guys. You can see TVIX. This is very good when there's volatility in the market. It goes up when the markets are selling off. And when the VIX, the volatility index, is green, right? You can see this was up 5% today. If we go to the TVIX ETF, it was up around the same, about 5%. SQQQ, watching this one for a potential NASDAQ sell-off. This does well when the NASDAQ is selling off, and the SPX ETF does well when the S&P 500 is selling off. So these are just a couple that I'm watching right now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. Leave a comment. Let me know how you guys did today. What are your thoughts on the market? And consider subscribing if you want to see further content from me, and hit that notification bell while you're at it so you're notified every single time that I do make a video. And go down below in the description box, guys, join our Strive Smart Facebook group and the Discord group chat, and follow me on Instagram and Twitter. All those are linked down below. So I'll catch you guys in the next video. I appreciate you all for watching again. Peace out. What's going on, everybody? It's Stas here.